So hello everyone, and welcome to a demo for the automation of the sales order report. And this has been presented by my colleague, Ms. Amrita Kulshrestha. These are the important other links. This is an email address, and this is the Blogspot link. Please do, once the demo is over, please give us your email address for the free sample package. So we have a complete package along with the TCP, which you can download and install on your machine. And any copy of any Excel spreadsheets that are to be automated from Tally are most welcome. Ms. Kulshrestha actually comes with more than 8 years of experience, and she's working with us. She has helped automate, she has done this project for automation for the end client. So first of all, now, sir, I'll come down to my client problem. What was the client problem which it was at? Now, the CEO of this particular company needed the consolidated sales order report with the billing by Godown. So for example, he wanted complete visibility starting from the original sales order down to sales invoice and delivery note and down to the billing receipt, right? Now, current status of the report is generated manually by the people, and the generation of this report requires at least one man-day, right? Now, there was a TDL team which had also made this particular report. But that TDL, that report actually takes more than 20 minutes to refresh on a single day. So therefore, the report was taking a lot of time to actually reload and refresh. So client requires an automation solution. So what the client wanted was a solution which is plug and play. The data extraction should be done in off-peak hours. So we had to store the data somewhere so that the Power BI or the module picks up the data when the report is to be done, and therefore we used JSON extract for it. We can also use Excel extract for it. The client had specifically indicated that for the sales order or the bill pending report, there should be no load on Tally during the working of the hours. The client also wanted the graphical and presentation and addition of more reports. He did not want any database on it installed because database maintenance was a problem for the client. He wanted a solution with minimal deployment requirements, minimal deployment requirements. He did not want to keep any backups. He wanted also the solution to be either on his machine or on the cloud. So the client is not a Microsoft customer. So therefore we finally intersynced it with Google Cloud and linked it up from there. And the client also had a low budget. So therefore the turnaround time for this solution needed to be very, very quick. So for those of you who are from the Tally background, we all know that there is a sales order due report. So there's date, there's order number, there's a name of the item, ordered quantity, and then there is a bill receivable report. Now here you see you have a sales ledger, and this particular sales ledger or the voucher transaction is linked up with a particular Godown. So client basically wants a consolidation of these two reports, right? It wants it in one single interface so the client can get a visibility of starting from the sales order to delivery notes, sales invoice, down to bill receivable details. Now, just to give you the, you know, how exactly it is, we start off with the sales order. Now, say after a sales order, you can have a delivery note. Now, this delivery note basically means that the item has been delivered, but no invoicing has been done. And then there's a sales invoice. So, but the delivery note actually is not an accounting activity, it's an inventory activity. And the sales invoice and the delivery notes are actually linked up with a tracking number. Now the sales order is also linked up with delivery note as well as the sales invoice to something called a reference number. And your sales invoice and the receipt details are linked up with the bill details. So there are actually three levels of hierarchy which are there. This particular sales order is actually linked up with item details, or it is linked up with Godown and the batch-wise details. So suppose it is, I'm looking at Godown and the batch-wise details. So your voucher entry can be done at either the voucher inventory level, or it can be done at the voucher inventory batch-wise level, right? So there are two levels of hierarchy which are actually involved in it. So this solution has been deployed across multiple clients, and here is a reference from one of our partners, DDS, Data Intelligence LLP. And with this, I transfer it to Amrita to showcase how she went about solving the solution. So Amrita, I give it to you.
Hello everyone, my name is Amrita Kudri and I will explain you the complete content of the automation of sales order report. The first is value proposition is reduced. It reduces data extraction time, it reduces business logical coding time, and it reduces maintenance time, and it reduces length of TDL code and reporting data size. It also reduces ETL development cost, and hence it helps in reducing BI cost. Secondly is RAISE. RAISE is ease of reporting, ability to handle large load. It provides ease of development and also RAISE number of concurrent users. Therefore, we can conclude here that it helps in recreating ready-made ETL process. It productizes the reporting output and aggregates for faster analysis. And it helps in eliminating cubes, custom functions, Excel spreadsheets, and split database install and hanging off time. Now the major area of focus on what we do offer to the industry. Ready-made extraction protects to consolidate compressed data from multiple sources in tally schema. The cost is lower coding time, faster data access, ease to use desktop server application using reporting tools, and wire value is the tally MIS, graphs, dashboard, time series analysis. The overall benefit of the and the major advantage of the services is it minimizes the number of pages. The data comparison it provides is so strong that it can convert the 100 pages of report to one page report. And the purpose of this report gives complete visibility by the sales order for sales invoice, delivery note, receipt, and the GST page. And it gives sales order pendency details by the godown. And here are the attached assumptions of the report are sales order, sales invoice, credit note, delivery note are linked up with the same reference number. Here, those delivery note have been included that are not a part of the sales invoice. In case a delivery note along with the sales invoice, then the sales invoice number is taken into the account. So here the data has been taken from the voucher inventory and the code is framed in SQL as shown below. After that, the same code is framed in the Power BI. And here fetching data from the voucher inventory based on the sales. So I will show you the document on the behalf of this. In this document, I am explain how each component of the report was developed. So first of all, I am fetching data from the voucher inventory table on the basis of sales. Here the data has been taken from voucher inventory and the code is framed in SQL and the same code is in DEX. So this is the SQL code and this is the DEX coding for this. First of all, I am summarizing data and select some columns basis on the sales order, like documented, voucher number, party ledger name, reference, company name, and some credit amount and some debit amount. Here the sum debit amount is calculated, the sum of voucher inventory table, column name is debit amount. And some credit amount is also calculated by the sum of credit amount from the voucher inventory table. After that, I am selecting some columns from the variable D, which is DEX coding, and calculated sales order amount using DEX. So here I am calculating SO amount, sales order amount. And take some variables, some columns like company name, cost center name, party name, SO number, SO date, and SO amount, and reference number. Cost center name and the reference number is doing format in string format for the join purpose. Now we are fetching data from the voucher inventory table on the basis of sales, which is framed in SQL and DEX both is stated below. In this, the sum credit amount and is calculated and given alias name, sum credit amount. And the same operation is performed for the debit amount, which is later is called by alias name, sum debit amount. Sum debit amount and sum credit amount. This is the DEX code for that. And I am filtering some columns here on the basis of sale. First is reference number, go down name, and company name, voucher number, master ID, and some credit amount, and some debit amount. Here we selected some column like cost center name, reference number, master ID, sales number, sales date column from the A1 sales voucher summarized column, which is here. After that, we are fetching data on the basis of delivery note, which is framed in SQL and DEX both. In this, the sum of credit amount is calculated and given alias name, some delivery note, credit delivery note, and the debit amount is calculated and alias name is debit delivery note, which is stored in B1 delivery summarized variable. And also select some column like reference, go down, document date, voucher number. Here the credit delivery note and debit delivery note. Now again we summarize debit delivery note. We summarize delivery note to here and coming data from the variable B1 delivery note summarize. So this is the DEX coding. I'm talking about that B1 delivery note summarize and select some column cost center name and format that in a string format, reference number, format that in string format for the joining purpose, and delivery note number, delivery note amount, and delivery note date. Delivery note amount is calculated, which is credit delivery note subtracted with the debit delivery note. After that, I am fetching data from the voucher inventory on the basis of credit note, basis on the credit note, and select some column like reference, go down, voucher number, and master ID. Here the credit note is calculated and debit credit note is also calculated, which is coming from the voucher inventory table, debit amount, sum of debit amount. After that, select some column of credit note like cost center name, reference number, bill number, credit note number, and credit note amount, and master ID C1. And finally, here I am do the join the final variable, sales order variable, and delivery note. So for that, I am using left method left outer join with the variable consolidate sales order variable and B2 delivery note summarize variable and store that value in the A1 delivery note and also do the distinct to remove the duplicates. Here, joining on the basis of reference number and cost center name, extract from the variable A1 delivery note. This is the DEX code. And with the A1 sales voucher summarize, I am do the joining between them and remove duplicate also. And stored in a variable, which is A2 delivery. After that, here again, joining is on the basis of reference number and cost center name and extracted from the variable A2 delivery note and B2 credit note summarize and remove duplicate also and stored in a variable which is A3 delivery. Here I am adding one column bill name on the basis of master ID from the voucher laser bill table for the receipt detail. So here I am adding a column which is bill name, and for that I do a lookup from the voucher laser bill name table, column name bill name, and voucher laser bill column name master ID. I do a lookup for bill name and stored in a variable which is A receipt. And also add a column which is master ID receipt. And same, do the lookup for that voucher laser bill on the basis of master ID and bill name. Then I do the filter for voucher sum table. Laser sum credit is greater than 0 and laser type parent is receipt. So here I am doing the filter on the basis of laser sum table. Then the format the entries for receipt filter and select the required columns, master ID, receipt, voucher number, and voucher date. So voucher amount, voucher date, and master ID receipt here. And finally, to join between those variables, which is B receipt and B receipt filter 2, I'm joining for receipt node and stored in a variable which is D receipt payment date. Here, we are fetching data from the voucher, laser sum table on the basis of taxes and duties, and which is framed in DAX. State below, in this the sum of credit amount is calculated and given alias name sum tax credit value, and the same operation is performed for the debit amount, which is later is called by alias name sum tax debit value. And here we are finding the sales invoice amount using master ID as a joint criteria and calculating GST amount here. And the tax debit is tax credit value is subtracted from the tax credit value. Here I am doing the join between a D receipt payment date and laser entry tax master ID and stored in a variable which is GST tax. Now we are finding the credit note invoice tax amount using master ID C1 as a join criteria. For extracting the GST amount, tax debit value is subtracted in the credit tax value. Here I am doing the join between GST tax variable and laser entry tax master ID credit note variable, which is here, and is stored in a variable GST tax credit. And finally, the variable GST tax credit output is stored, that is go down by sales report, and return that variable GST tax credit. So the final result, the number of matching with tally, refresh and reload time on 8GB machine less than 30 seconds for 2 years of data. And the finally output is that, and I will show you the code of that in Power BI. This is the code for that I do in the DAX code.
And Amrita, can you show through extraction and the refresh also?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Sure.
So basically, this has got more than 45 reports in Tally and a single plug-and-play module. So we will be showing you how the data is extracted. And then simply you have to click the refresh button and the entire Power BI module. So it's completely plug and play we have made, you know, and you can generate your own reports. So she will show you how it is done.
Go to the extract companies.
So she's loaded the TCP, she's extracted the companies.
Go to the manage local TTL and add that path, which is a TCP path here, and add that. Go to the extract companies, and here the file is coming from Tally in the Excel mode. And go to the Power BI app. and refresh it.
And automatically all the reports, so there are about more than 40 reports which are consolidated, which relate with GST, ledger classification, cost center allocation, go down wise analysis, sales order analysis, and all these reports are there. So this is a ready-made module and it can be plugged in with the Google Drive and taken. So we have taken one report which was there, and we have a lot sought to explain how we have made it as a plug and play module. Now, sir,
I have a query. That is, first you did something in Tally, that is, you generated JSON that comes to one particular file, then you are doing that refresher. Right?
Yes, sir. Because the reason we are putting it in JSON or in Excel is so that the client has the option of extracting the data during the off-peak hours. So the whole thing is that the client stores this data. And once this data is in JSON or in Excel, then I can actually integrate it either with Microsoft Cloud or with Google Cloud. Both are possible. So client has the option of going both the ways. So all this can be, you know, a client need not even keep a desktop solution. Client can actually simply go straight away to the cloud. We will link it up with the Google Drive. Put these Excel files, and then from there, we will link it up with the cloud-based solution. That is possible.
Okay.
So here you see, Amrita, you can show all the other reports of stock movement by Godown, ABC, ledger balance. There are various other reports. Each one has a view, stock movement by Godown, ABC, ledger balance, receivable analysis balances. So there is a lot of, one is to simply see the Tally data on your mobile, but one is actually automating all your Excel spreadsheet. So that is now the solution is in such a way that we can do it plug and play. And the turnaround times can be also very, very fast.
Okay, good.
So for those people who are part of this now receivable turnover report, now Amrita, go down to payable turnover, then go to daybook view. Okay. Now in this daybook view, we have taken three actually these things. We have taken voucher inventory, ledger sum, and voucher ledger. Ledger bill. So we have started out with voucher inventory, then voucher ledger sum, which is ledger, and then voucher ledger bill. We've taken three views, consolidated views. So as a this thing is, the first step is that of course, for those of you who have attended this webinar, we will deploy it. We'll give you the link and we'll deploy it free of cost so that you can see the product, see the module on your own data. And that is this thing. And any then Excel reports which you need to be automated, the team is there.
Okay. You have a